Good afternoon. I am very much, I'm grateful to attend this symposium, and so I'm grateful to the organizers for giving me this opportunity to address you through this video. The title of my presentation is Professor Marcus, 50 years of special attraction. I first met Professor Marcus during his visit to the Institute of Mathematics of the Polish Academy of Sciences in 1966. His main contact at the Institute was Czesław Pawlak, but he also had contact with a group of linguists and war students. I was his local guide during this and subsequent visits, taking him to various places in Warsaw and Vienna. He also met my parents, and they became friends. Their correspondence went smoothly. During his visit in 1968, he gave a lecture on contextual grammars. The lecture was very inspiring, and a couple of days later I showed him a number of results I could prove based on the material he presented in his lecture. I was probably the first researcher outside Romania working on contextual grammars. Professor Marcus was very pleased with this results, which made me very proud of his still very young researcher, and he invited me to come to Bucharest so that we could have more discussions. My visit took place at the beginning of 1969. He was a very nice host, and moreover, this visit was very special. This was the only invited scientific visit abroad during my stay in Poland. We shared a lot of books. I was regularly sending him books, and also some of them never reached him, he still received many books from me. He told me a number of times that he was amazed by my intuition on his taste in books. All the books he received were very interesting. As a matter of fact, one of the nicest compliments I got from Professor Marcus was his statement when we met in Turku in 2014, it is so nice to have a friend who is on the same wavelength. The most characteristic feature of Professor Marcus that I have observed during the 50 years of our friendship were his modesty and gentle manners, his over childish curiosity and enthusiasm, his ability to tell stories where scientific ideas and personal recollections were intertwined in a fascinating way. His impressively deep and broad knowledge about the topics of his research lectures. When I heard in March from George Pound that Professor Marcus was taken to Elias Hospital, I called him there and with malicious luck got right away with the phone. After some initial confusion caused by the fact that his hearing wasn't there, he realized that it is me calling. He switched them to English, and the first thing he said was, I quote, "Your call here is a sign of our special friendship," end of quotation. Indeed, he was a very special friend. When on March 17th, I learned that Professor Marcus passed away, my first reaction was a deep sadness. My special friend is not with us anymore. But a short time later, I decided that we should not mourn him, but rather we should celebrate his uniquely wonderful and inspiring life. We certainly celebrate him at this symposium by just remembering what a unique human being he